All right. Well, welcome, everybody. This is the inaugural Minnesota Bass Nation podcast. Throughout the season this year, we're going to be doing several podcasts. We're going to be focusing on the team trail, of course. We're going to be looking at the state team heading down to Iowa in June. We're going to be talking about the Tournament of Champions in August. So we have a lot of things that we are planning with this podcast. And tonight we're starting out with Team Trail because our first tournament's coming up in less than 2 weeks up on Lake Vermilion. And my name is Peter Perovich. I am the president of the Minnesota Bass Nation. Greg, who's the tournament director, couldn't be with us tonight. He's under the weather. And Steve Johnson has joined us tonight. Normally, Steve would be behind the scenes, but he is basically our engineer and our producer that's going to be taking care of all the video. Our guests tonight are Andy Walls. Andy has been with us since day one, I believe, Andy.
And yeah, we started the first year for sure.
Yeah. So he's one of our veteran anglers, and Keith Tuma is also here, but he had to duck out for a minute to get out of the way of the storm. I'm sure he'll be joining us here shortly. And then we got Pete from Omnia, and Omnia is our title sponsor this year for the team trail. And I believe, Pete, you guys have been with us for the last few seasons anyway.
Yep.
And it's been absolutely fantastic having you on. So as we go through tonight, we're going to talk a little bit about our spot. We're going to talk with our sponsors, obviously, Pete. We're going to talk about the trail, the season, what to expect, the championship, how you get there. And then we're going to look at the end here before we sign off. We're going to talk with these guys about Vermilion and their thoughts and things like that. So first, I want to thank all of our sponsors for the year. We're always adding more, but right now we've got Omni as our title, Swagger Tackle as our presenting. Intune Marine is back on board this year. Prop MD is back on board. Blackfish, All Terrain, MG Lures, Minn Kota, Hummingbird are all on board with our team trail. We thank each and every one of you. I mean, we couldn't be doing this without you guys. And, you know, we love to partner up with our sponsors and do the best we can at getting you guys to go their way to purchase products and use their services. So, with that said, again, Pete from Omni is with us. Pete, thanks for joining us.
No, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you.
So, I mean, what draws you to sponsoring the Minnesota Bass Nation, especially the team trail?
That's a good question. There's some selfish reasons, and there's also from a business aspect. It definitely any trail or any sort of tournament circuits that are affiliated with Bassmaster tend to carry a lot of clout. They're legitimate tournament trails, that they're run well, that they're going to get some exposure for your brand. I really like the format of the team trail, and I love the direction it's been going over the last couple of years. We've seen the team trail get aggressive at upping up those entry fees and getting those payouts big and aggressive, so that, you know, at times in Minnesota, we get lapses in those really good high level tournament competitions that are all over the whole state. That's why I bring up the selfish side. Selfishly, as an angler that like a lot of the anglers fishing the team trail, I've got a full-time job, right? So I'm not committed like some of my friends that are fishing professionally all over the country to fishing full-time, to taking 2 weeks off of work, a week off of work every time I have a tournament. And the highest level of competition for a long time in the state, I get a lot of grief from this from a lot of fed guys and all that, but I felt for a long time was always in the Denny's on Lake Minnetonka, and it was just because of the fact that payouts were really well. The best anglers I felt full field were there, but it was missing a lot of these world-class, really good anglers from all around the rest of the state that weren't going to drive all the way down to Lake Minnetonka and just fish that one fishery all the time. So you saw Lake Minnetonka kicking all these world-class anglers out into the opens and into the elite series and these high-level anglers. But yet there was all these other high-level anglers in the state that just weren't getting the shine because they were nowhere near Lake Minnetonka. So when I saw Team Trail get those payouts up into that really legitimate high-level competition payouts, you are now seeing anglers from around the whole state that are really good fishermen that deserve the attention that just like the city Minnetonka guys always got. That really excited me because I myself also wanted to see us take advantage of the fact we live in a state with 10,000 awesome lakes. There isn't just right, yep. There isn't one lake to just beat your brains in on, but it always had this high level of competition on it with the Seth Fighters and the Dean Capras and the Austin Felix's and Andy Young's, all these anglers that made it to that next level were all there. And the payout structure made sense for that level of competition. And so I personally am very proud of the Minnesota Bass anglers that have put this together. Hey, Keith, glad to see you. All right.
Yeah. Keith. I don't know what's going on. We got a bad storm, tornado. Sorry to interrupt.
Not at all. But Keith's a perfect example of what I'm saying. You see what Keith was able to do last year and his success on a national level, Andy as well. And I think Team Trail's giving and Bassmaster's giving these anglers in the whole state an opportunity now to show how high level anglers there are outside of the metro and outside of the Lake Minnetonka beatdown that just happens every single year to even this guy here, myself. So I'm really excited myself and to get out of the bubble of the metro and get to enjoy a state full of awesome lakes and incredible anglers and showcase all of it.
Yeah, it's really for us when we decided to do this 5 years ago, we put a basically a 3 to 5 year plan into action back then. And right now we're in our fifth year. I think where we are where we want to be this year. Yeah. And the quality of anglers that we've maintained over the years and that we gained this year is proving that.
It's stout. So, it's really stout. And that's honestly, I got to give you kudos for that, Peter and Steve and Greg and everybody involved with the Team Trail on the backside, getting it all organized. It's been hard in Minnesota to get momentum for a trail, traveling trail around the whole state and showcasing the whole state to get all the best anglers all jumping into the same thing. And I think in my time anyway, fishing tournaments, this has been the most successful run I'd seen at doing this to get really quality anglers from all over the whole state to compete at a high level. So kudos to you guys.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, thank you so much.
I think when we announced and we opened it up for registration, I think we maxed out. We completely filled up in like a week.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. It was very, very, very quick. So, Pete, when an angler, any of the viewers watching this.
Yeah.
I mean, how does Omnia work? I know it's an online store.
Yep.
So when they go onto your site and they have some choices of how they want to purchase your tackle and equipment. So why don't you give us a little bit about that?
Well, you could show us how to do this. We could switch it to a screen and we could do a quick thing on the website.
Yeah, we can certainly do that if you'd like. We give you two options basically as a consumer at Omnia right now. And to be honest, there's a lot more to come. But the concept of Omnia actually was concepted by our three founders. That came, two of them from the industry, one from the tech side of the world, that wanted to give anglers, all anglers of all levels, whether we rank anglers in our system is 1 through 10s, right? 1 being somebody who gets forced to go fishing sometime with their brother-in-law or something and doesn't really want to go, and a 10 as being your Andy Walls and Keith Tumas that are hardcore competitive anglers that fish all over the country and really don't need all that super good advice, but are happy to do some homework if they can get it on a new body of water they may be traveling to. But the big box stores, we felt, were not giving the anglers the ability to shop by the bodies of water anymore. And why we say that is, I worked in a big box store for a long time. And anglers would come up to you, most anglers in that, I'd say that 1 to 6 range of level skill level of angler. Andy Walls can speak to this in his time selling tackle too. They come up to you and say, I'm going to this lake. What do I need? They don't necessarily say, what's better, a Corrado DC or Tatula SV? That's not the question they're asking. They're going to ask, I'm going to this lake and I want to catch a walleye, or I'm going to this lake and we want to catch some bass and pike or whatever else swims. And you're helping them shop by the body of water that they're fishing. So at Omnia, we give you the ability to actually shop by lake. So you can actually click on Find My Lake and you can look and you can just, it's algorithm driven. We have every single body of water in the United States mapped. So you can actually pick, you know, Pelican Lake in Orr or Lake Minnetonka in Minnesota here, and you can go to Lake.
Get away, the secrets on Pelican, that's a hidden
gem. Yeah, for sure. it's not a catch app. It doesn't give any location or anything like that. It's basically just giving you a fishing report. And now you can upload videos and pictures, and you can basically help anglers say, hey, I was using a jig and a minnow. I was using a topwater, a spook and fluorocarbon leader with braided line and run and casting on windy points, you know, or whatever they were doing. And they can give anglers those tips. And if anglers purchase off your fishing report, you actually get tackle credit. And the more fishing reports you do and the more tackle credits you're earning, you can move up to actually like $10 a purchase that you're gaining. It's helping the community learn how to basically target species of fish. It's not helping them locate fish. That's something we all just have to get out on the water and learn how to do, but it's helping them choose their tackle wisely when they're shopping online. So, we give people that option, and then we also give people this the traditional shopping that, you know, if you do want to just know the difference between a Tatula SV and a Corrado DC, that's there too.
Right. It's really interesting. It's a way that I've never shopped before, and it's really helpful.
It's taking really off faster than I thought it would. I thought we if you can notice by the assortment, you guys can appreciate this. Our assortment started off pretty much on the high end of bass tackle. We're bringing in the high end bass tournament anglers and avid anglers to prove out the system. And also avid bass anglers can give a better fishing report. They can actually explain a little better what's working on these bodies of water. And then it's going to help those, as we assort for more entry-level anglers, it will have all those reports filled out. What I can announce here tonight now finally is we're making that much easier because Omnia is launching our mobile apps. Actually, they're hitting the stores today. So Apple and Android will have the Omnia apps. You can do your fishing reports from your phone, right on the body of water you're on if you want, and just shoot a video, take a picture. You can shop from your phone now in your boat and get free shipping if you're premium and all that. If you're running out of Senkos and you need one bag, you can hit the button and get it shipped to you. It's going to be cool. And on next Thursday, sadly for me, why I will not make the first team trail event and be fishing Vermilion, which I'm very upset about, to be honest with you, but I will be in studio doing our stream on our new app of Bassmaster Live, and we are going to be doing it live and shoppable. So you'll actually be able to shop on our website or shop on our app while watching the Bassmaster Live. We'll actually be posting up the baits, and the video will move around with you as you shop, so you don't have to actually leave the video to shop and add the items to cart that they're catching them on as you're watching the event.
That's pretty cool. That is really cool.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
I was looking at your YouTube page today.
Yeah.
And I really like you do these little feature showcases on rods, reels, those sorts of things, new items you got in stock. And as a club guy that was very, very new to tournament fishing, it was very cool, excuse me, to, you know, because I've only fished local stuff.
Yeah.
But, you know, with the club stuff, our club liked to travel all over the state to hit other bodies of water. And I could look at a lake and be like, all right, I need to get gear up for this. Otherwise, yep. You know, right. I wouldn't know if I'm going for largemouth or smallmouth. I could go to your website and say, this time of year, I'm going to be doing a drop shot a lot more, or
yep.
pound of the bank, or I'm going to have to go after suspended fish offshore. So that's really good, especially for these guys that the younger guys that have never fished that body of water before.
Correct. Yep. And I think it'll really bear a lot of fruit as far as a shot by lake when we get into multi-species fishing. We have panfish assortments and walleye assortments and redfish and snook assortments and all that stuff.
And the so ice fishing too.
Yeah. Yeah. Ice fishermen, I know, will jump on it when we're assorted for all that. Cause it's really going to help more destination anglers than anything. And also tournament anglers as well that are traveling around the country.
Right. Yep. Absolutely. Absolutely. So how does, you have an ambassador program.
Yep.
So how does our viewers out there, if they think they want to be an ambassador, how do they go about doing that?
Correct. It's evolving as we speak. You know, we did it initially to help anglers start filling out those, filing those fishing reports and give them a way to earn credit. But what we found is it's actually starting to work a lot with a lot of manufacturers, sponsored anglers to start showing their value to their sponsors. They can go out there and file fishing reports and show that they're using X lures or X rods and reels and all that stuff and having success and how they're using it. And people are purchasing off of it. We actually provide reports to their manufacturer partners to help them get those, to get pats on the back for doing their job for their sponsors. So, but the ambassador program has three levels, silver, gold, and blue. The blue level, is actually a partner page of ours, like Seth Fighter is a partner of ours. So, sure. Those are kind of affiliate paid, cash paid out kind of level anglers that are really moving product, doing a lot of stuff for us. But that gold level, you're earning $10 every purchase you make. You can post videos instead of just pictures on your reports. We basically start to trust you that your reports aren't crappy, because we get that question a lot. Well, how do I know somebody doesn't go on there and post a bunch of junk? Well, literally, we have a staff that reviews fishing reports and makes sure. And once we see someone's doing a good job and they're good at their job and they're actually being on it and it's helping people and people like the reports, then it's good for them, whether they're a guide or whatever, we can elevate them up to that gold level, and they can earn larger amounts of credit and really start making a little business out of it for themselves.
Sure. Well, that's fantastic. That's fantastic. So yeah, with our viewers out there, Pete from Omnia, that was very good. Pete, I really enjoy listening about that because it's such a unique way to shop.
Yeah.
And you know, Omnia has a YouTube page out there, correct?
Yeah, we got YouTube. We haven't really dove into it hard with both feet. I, as you guys can imagine, we were a startup. We really didn't even go into retail till about 3 years ago. Andy was just recently in and visited us for a minute, and he could point it out. We basically are out of people space, and we all do a whole bunch, wear a bunch of hats. So our content team runs really, really hard. So they've been kind of focusing on a little bit of social stuff so far, but we have some new media partnerships that we'll be announcing soon. And we're really investing into that side of the business in the upcoming months here. We'll be moving in the fall when we'll have a larger facility with a studio, and we can really dive into doing some higher level content pieces and stuff.
All right. Well, we're going to be looking forward to seeing that. That's for sure.
So do we have a quick minute here? Can we take a look at the website?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you sure. Show me the lake real quick. Let me share a screen here.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Chrome tab. Let's do. There we go. Share. All right. So now we're looking. I'm looking at the Omnia's page. Do you guys see it?
Yep.
Yep.
All right. So we're going to do this lakes and fish. We're going to find a lake. We're going to look at Vermilion.
Okay.
Why would we look at Vermilion?
That's Allen Lake. We got to go up whip a little bit more.
Hopefully there's a fishing report that says it's not frozen anymore.
Right.
So the other day when I was on there looking, there was no report that said it was open water.
Yeah, well.
I've checked. It's a cool feature.
Look at that, zooming in. Well, that's Vermilion Lake. That's Cass. That's the wrong one.
Wrong one. So
we're looking for Tower.
Well, just do an example. You don't need to go to Vermilion.
Find it there.
Just do an example so people can kind of see what exactly it is they're going to be searching for.
Easy low-hanging fruit ones like Minnetonka. There's only one of those. So, but that took you to another Lake Vermilion. There you go.
I didn't know there were so many Vermilion.
Oh, yeah. That's the fun part. You got to know exactly where you're going with all the lakes we got in this state.
I did the same one again.
You can actually scroll up on the map and just go up into the northeast corner of the state and go right to the Vermilion pin if you'd like.
Wowzers.
There's farther north. There it is. Top right corner.
There we go.
Yep, there you go. Go to the orange tab there. Yeah, there you go.
See, do we go see lake details?
Yep, you can go to see lake details there. So there's... and then you can actually view fishing reports. You can actually see soon to be, we just launched our tournament pages feature. So all the tournament, directors will be uploading all the tournament information, even results. So you can see the tournaments that are taking place on the lake, the schedules for tournaments throughout the season on that body of water. You can filter it by species, by season. So if you want to, summertime walleye trip you're taking up there, you can actually see reports for that. But I obviously, we're as bass anglers, it'd be some spring and pre-spawn. So there you go. You see some hair jigs there, a little fire tip or smallmouth fishing in the spring here. So and some jerk baits. So, you know, if you think about it, if you're an angler that's never been to Vermilion, it's an easy way to find some stuff that's actually worked and caught fish for people. Yep. And then we at the bottom there, you'll always see we'll do relevant content down there to help the angler learn how to fish his hair jig, what products to purchase with their hair jigs, the fluorocarbon, the braided or fluorocarbon leader, braided line, the spinning rods and reels that go with the basically can hand walk somebody through fishing on that body of water for whatever species they're after.
There's just a wealth of knowledge in here.
Yeah. Yeah, and the funny thing is it's crazy because it's an algorithm and it's learning. So think about what these pages will look like in a couple of years with all the current and new and more information, the more tech we're rolling into it. It's going to turn into something pretty special. A really nice feature for all of us on our phones if we're driving around scouting new lakes and things like that as well.
All right, that's fantastic. Thanks so much, Pete.
Yeah, thanks for showing that, Steve. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. I'm going to have to dive into this later for sure.
All right. Again, that was Pete from Omnia. Omnia is our 2022 title sponsor this year for the team trail. We're extremely excited about that. So visit Omnia online, omnia.com, I believe.
They were with us last year too, weren't they, Peter?
What's that?
You guys were with us last year too, right?
Correct. Yep. We jumped on board last year.
Yep.
In fact, we just lost him. He got in one sentence and we lost him.
In fact, the team trail, the team trail anglers will be able to order product all week long before the tournament and we'll get it up to you guys on Friday night or Saturday morning. So that's happening again. So,
And I will not be delivering them. Because I I'm going to pout and probably point this out 10 more times that I am not fishing the tournament that I signed up for.
All right. Well, thank you, Pete.
You're welcome.
So as I was talking about earlier, I'm going to do a quick rundown of the season this year for the tournament trail. Again, May 22nd, we're at Lake Vermilion in Tower, Minnesota. Blast off will be at 7 a.m. The weigh-in will start at 3. And then from there, we're headed to Leech Lake up in Walker on June 19th. And in July, we're headed to the Whitefish Chain in Cross Lake. In August, we will be on Lake Minnetonka again. Well, we weren't there last year, though, were we? No.
No, I don't think so.
Not last year.
We weren't. We weren't. So we're back on Minnetonka this year. So I know we do get some questions about the championship. The championship will be August 28th. And we are really going on this one. We're going out to Big Stone Lake out in Ortonville. So the championship, of course, it consists of the top 20 teams after the four regular season events. They advance with based on points. However, this year you are going to be able to get to that championship in two different ways. So you are going to be able to get there, obviously, points. That remains, of course, but we are also qualifying the four regular season events champions. Sweet. If you win an event, you automatically qualify for the championship.
Yeah. So I got one shot, you're telling me. I still got a shot at baseball.
So, but it, the only caveat there is there's no double qualifying. So, we're going to kind of keep in line with Bassmaster on that one, like the Opens. We, you know, if you double qualify, we go to the next guy.
Move spot down. That's cool.
Yep. So anyway, yeah, so that's basically our season. We are absolutely looking forward to it. Hopefully all the venues work the way we like them to work. The one thing that I will tell you guys, this year was probably one of our toughest years ever getting venues.
Yeah.
And I did hear that from some other trails. They said, you know, we talked to Classic Bass, and they had the same issues. A lot of problems getting venues, but I think we got everything down ready to go. So we're good there. So basically, and oh, also in, like Pete said, he's fishing. So he's fishing the trail also.
Yeah.
So if you come out to watch the weigh-in and whatnot, Pete will be there.
Yep.
You can talk to him about Omnia and whatnot. So don't forget that. Mm-hmm. And I think at this time, Steve, we're just going to take a quick 30-second break, right?
Yep.
Okay, we're just going to take a quick break, and then we're going to come back to Andy and Keith. We'll be right back. right. Welcome back, everybody. So again, this year, Keith Tuma, Andy Walls are fishing our team trail. They've been with us from the beginning, from the first season. And they've stuck it out with us. They've been to Nationals a couple of times. These guys are our veteran anglers. They are just quite amazing. We had our Women Lake tournament last year. This team came in with the biggest bag I've ever seen at a tournament in Minnesota. Mm-hmm. It was what, north of 27 pounds, Andy, I believe.
Yeah, just almost 27 and a quarter, maybe. I don't remember. It was a birthday present. It was all pretty special. The number doesn't matter. It was a fun day. I'll never forget.
Yeah, it was fun.
Usually, you know, our club has done tournaments on Woman Lake, and you know, a lot of other clubs have done it in the spring and stuff. And we wanted to give Woman Lake a break and do it earlier or later in the season, and not have like a spring tournament on Woman.
Absolutely.
But you know, we were thinking we might see a couple bags over 20, but we like half the field was over 20. Right about.
Yeah, it was a crazy day.
A really special one. A lot of the fish bit, I think. It was, you know, just one of those days where you really couldn't do too much wrong if you were on the right area.
Right.
Yeah, it didn't matter what you drew. Yeah, it was amazing. Yeah. Really fun day.
It was so fun. And it was really fun for us to be weighing those fish in, and every bag, I mean, we were just like, oh my God, oh my God.
Yeah.
So it just, I mean, it really tells you with the team trail, the quality of anglers that this trail has. These guys know what they're doing. And
yeah,
it's just, and like I said before, I mean, this year's roster looks even better. And we're looking so forward to it. So, but what else you got going, Andy?
You know,
fishing any opens this year or anything like that?
I tried to. I got registered a little late, but I'm pretty low on the waiting list. I didn't make any of those. So doing the team trail, I'm substituting. So I'm going to fish the International Falls or the I Falls Bass Classic or Championship, the smallmouth tournament on Rainy on the American side there. So I get to do that one. But that's about it, really. Keith and I were planning on doing the Minnetonka Classic, but work got in the way for me. So unfortunately, I won't be able to do that one.
Somehow I have a feeling Andy's going to try and steal some of my money on Tuesday nights on Minnetonka too this year, I bet.
I will definitely be at a couple of those.
Sure. Yeah, I kind of figure.
Well, that's great. I've actually fished that International Falls tournament before, three times. It is actually a blast. They do such a nice job with that.
So I've wanted to do it since day one. I have actually grown up, my cabin's on Rainy Lake. So I've been there since I was a little kid. I used to go to the Fort Francis one with my grandpa when I was like six and watch the weigh-ins and blast offs. Like, you know, I was that kid. So it's definitely one I've wanted to do forever. And I'm really excited about it. It should be a fun time for sure.
Oh, absolutely. It is a great time. The whole city gets involved.
Yeah,
the whole city gets involved.
Parade and you name it.
It is so cool. It is just a riot. So, but that's great. Obviously, we're glad to have you guys back.
Happy to be here. Wouldn't be anywhere else. This is
always count on you guys being there for our team trail because it's just.
Well, Greg red flagged our entry fee right away. I don't know what was going on there.
That was me when I signed up.
Oh, is that what it was? I'm trying to keep the dumb comments to a minimum here because I think every time I make a silly comment, I get booted off because of the weather or whatever. Weather.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So, and again, Keith Tuma, and now he's back on. He's had some issues with the weather up there. You're in North Dakota, I understand.
I'm staying with a friend of mine in Wahpeton right now. This weekend, we got a little derby.
And I think we're losing him again.
We lost him again.
Keith, are you with us?
I think he's going to drop again.
He's going to drop again.
Andy, tell us what it was like down at the championship for Nationals.
they're always a blast. That's really the reason we love fishing this. Outside of the tournaments being run fantastic, the opportunity is super cool, right? It's really exciting, and it's awesome. We've made it to three of them. The third one here was on Eufaula this last December, and both of Keith and I's first time in Alabama fishing, and it was different for sure. Like it was an experience. We're getting kind of a little more used to, especially Keith, with doing some of the opens and having some of that experience, the 200 boat stuff. Yeah. That's a completely, you know, on the bigger lakes, it's better, but I mean, you'd be surprised how small some of these places fish that are pretty large, and you know, there's people everywhere, and it's different. So, but it's a blast, you know, it's so much fun. The events are run really well, and you know, it's a challenge. We love that. I like getting out there and trying new things. And, you know, Eufaula, we both feel like we would love redemption on that one. We were close the whole time, and we just didn't figure it out until like noon on day two. And I mean, we actually had a chance to catch a bag to maybe even put us pretty close to making it. Like we found some fish and we were catching them pretty decent, and it was fun, you know. And that's the exciting part, is like that opportunity, right? And then when you get those close chances at it, it just elevates your interest even more and gets you more hungry. And yeah, I love it. Like that Eufaula was a blast, and the team championship is definitely worth going after, for in my opinion. Like it's worth everything for sure.
Oh yeah, I mean, and that's what, you know, that's the big thing with our trail, is there is a means to the end.
Yeah.
There's a national chance of getting to the Bassmaster Classic through this trail.
Yeah.
And you know, that's the one thing we love about it, is we push it hard. You know, we had a last year on Waconia. We had a blast with the championship. You know, we had 15 boats out there.
Yeah.
So it's a little smaller group, and you guys are just, you know, hammering on it and trying to get down to the next level. And looks like this year it's going to be on Hartwell, I think. Ooh. Is what it looks like. So that'll always be interesting to get
that
there,
is
too.
The ultimate goal this year for sure. Hartwell, that one excites us. Keith was just there for the classic. So
yep.
Hopefully he'll do better the next time around.
Well, yeah, right? He improved every day, so I'm just expecting him to just climb the team up. And if I catch anything, sure, it's a bonus, right?
Right. Yeah. It's a lake.
He should have looked at Omnia's page, and that'll tell him what baits to use. I tell you, I had my fantasy picks for the fantasy fishing were, if it could have just ended on day one, I had four guys in the top 10 on day one, and Andy. So, I'm gonna have to give him a little grief if he could ever stay connected, but
yeah.
It sounded like he had a really good time.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I'm
Keith
sure
had a great time.
Yeah.
I talked to him a couple of times via text, and he was pretty psyched. So yeah, he's back.
Making another run. Right.
Do you want me to just talk really, really fast? I could get a whole bunch of crap out. And
yeah,
I'm gonna
So besides the team trail, Keith, what do you got going this summer? What are you doing?
I'm doing the Northern Opens. And then, like I said, this little tournament this weekend on Big Stone. So I'm up staying with a friend of mine in Wapton. And he and I are going to fish that one on Sunday. Kind of get a feel for the lake, I guess, just in case Andy and I make the championship in the fall for the MNBN. But doing the Northern Swing on the Opens this year. I just had my first one. It was just before Easter weekend, and that was on the James River out of Richmond, Virginia. And first time I'd ever been to that place, and tidal fishery, which is really, really interesting, and a river, which is kind of my nemesis, but ended up 14th out of 225. So pretty stoked with that finish.
Absolutely.
Five ounces out of the top 10 cut.
Yeah, that's end points. You get some good points for that. So
it's a heck of a way to start the year. So it's fun. We're on Oneida in July. I'm sorry to interrupt you.
But no, go ahead.
I was going to say we're on Oneida in July, and then we've never been there either, but smallmouth and largemouth there, from what I understand. And then after that, in September, I think we shoot over to Chesapeake Bay, which will be another tidal fishery. So it should be fun.
Yeah, that'll be great. We constantly keep an eye on you as you're fishing those opens.
That's awesome. I do appreciate it. I get the messages.
And lost him.
And lost him again. Well, you know, and looking at Keith, and I kind of knew last year, Andy, you were talking about fishing the opens this year. That's one of the things that we like to do, because you are basically part of the Minnesota Bass Nation family, fishing the team trail. Keith has been a club member for many years. We like to keep up with you guys, and we want to know what you're doing and where you are. And if I get an opportunity to showcase you guys on Facebook or the website or something like that, we certainly do that. Because we do,
yeah,
we do throw
family here. We can feel it for sure.
Yep. I mean, we like to throw the support behind you guys. So, but with that said, I'm going to go into, we're up at Vermilion a week from Sunday. Do you have anything about Vermilion that you're, I mean, I'm not going to ask you for spots. I'm not going to, you know, ask you what you're throwing, what you're doing. It's just, how do you feel about the lake at this time of year?
It's going to be really fun. I think with the weather leading up to the tournament, like the late ice out, I think probably had everybody kind of on pins and needles, a little on edge and kind of wondering what it was going to be. But with the weather coming, I think they should be biting pretty good. Where they're going to be, I don't know. It could be interesting. You know, everyone was probably thinking it was going to be like a spawning tournament, and I don't think we're going to see anything like that. I think it's going to be a little more of an open book. It's going to allow the lake to fish probably a little bigger, and I think it's going to make it more exciting. The weight should be a little closer, and I think maybe even a little higher than what it would be if it was, you know, the ice had gone out maybe 2 weeks ago.
Spawning tournament, so.
Yeah.
What do you think? So what species do you think is going to play more, largemouth or smallmouth?
The smallmouth are probably going to play more, I would assume. But either one can certainly win it. That lake has very big largemouth and smallmouth. Vermilion's kind of a cool lake like that, where it's probably going to be more weather dependent than anything, and what people are able to fish and how they're able to fish. And yeah, like it can be one with either. It really could, for sure.
For everybody out there that's watching while I have signal here, I am like a smallmouth. I'm here for a few seconds and then I'm gone. Yeah. And then I'm going to fill back up for a little bit and then I'm gone.
Right. Well, we're doing a little bit of a preview of Vermilion.
Absolutely.
So just get your thoughts on the upcoming tournament. What kind of shape the lake going to be in? What are you guys thinking?
I'm hoping we don't have to dodge icebergs.
Yeah.
I've been getting a lot of text messages asking about the ice, and I don't have any answers right now. Warm days. Go ahead, Keith.
Oh, I was going to say, I did hear that the walleye tournament was canceled. That was right before our tournament up there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, I don't think we're going to run into that. I think we're going to be okay from what I'm being told. It could be 3 or 4 days out when we get there.
48 degree water temperature. That's fine.
Yeah. Yeah. But it's been warm and sunny, and hopefully they get a ton of rain to burn some of that ice off.
We do have blade baits in stock at Omnia for that happens.
Yeah, there you go.
What are you saying, Pete?
If you're so fishing we asked, 15 feet from the edge of the ice. Yeah.
So, Keith, we asked Andy a little bit about the TOI last year and going on to Nationals and what his feelings were about that being, you know, with this trail, those are that is the carrot.
I missed most of what you said, Peter. I'm so sorry. It locked up.
Oh, you locked up. I'm just gonna go to you about the team of the year last year in Waconia.
Yeah.
And then the Nationals, how things went for you guys. And Andy talked a little bit about that already. We just kind of want to get your thoughts on that, being that fishing this team trail, I mean, that is the goal, is to get to that national tournament, to get to the Classic, correct?
Absolutely. So, it's not an easy road to the Classic, but this is definitely another option or avenue that got.
Oh no!
That was abrupt.
That was abrupt.
Yeah, saw something you really liked this time, because
Keith Tuma. Thank you, Keith Tuma. We really appreciate that.
I'm pretty sure we're gonna have all you guys on again later this year. That's for sure.
Well, no, we will. That's obvious. So,
well, we got to catch him to make it back on here. Don't give me credit.
You guys are always gonna, every season, you guys are gonna have a target on your back, because you guys are solid, solid sticks.
I appreciate for that. Sure. I don't mind a target.
Yeah, I mean, you guys kind of are. I got to be honest with you. You guys, a lot of angers look around. They're like, "Oh, Walls of Tumor are here," and I'm like, "Well, yeah, they're here."
I mean, I wouldn't miss it for anything, right?
So, but this year, I mean, like again, like I was saying about the roster this year, well, it's pretty impressive.
It is. It is.
Super exciting.
I am so excited for this. And of course, we're going to do our best to make everything go like normal, very smooth for you guys and to get you out there fishing. Again, for all the team trail anglers this year, I think Greg will be sending you guys out. Either Greg or Sally will be sending you guys out an email about the Saturday night meeting, our annual. We basically only have one angler meeting for the year, and then of course Greg says a little something to you guys in the morning at the other tournaments, but we want to make sure everybody's on board with rules and whatnot, or if they have any questions or anything like that. So that'll happen up at Vermilion is when we'll have our big team, our team trail meeting with all the anglers. So and then basically take off time on Sunday, and I am so looking forward to this. I personally love going to Vermilion for these tournaments. We've had such great times there. We've had divisionals there for the Bass Nation, where Bassmasters come up a couple of 2-3 times and set up there, and they love it. They wanted to come back again. We couldn't close the deal to do it, but I know John Stewart from Bassmaster wanted to come back. So
are we still coming back? We're just not going to Vermilion.
Well, I don't know yet. I don't really know. That's going to be for a later.
Okay.
A later show. But, anyway, I don't know that we're going to be able to keep Keith in there. Anything else? Any last words, comments, Pete?
I really appreciate you guys having me on and giving Omnia some shine. I appreciate all the angler support. We get a lot of support throughout the whole year from all the team trail anglers, so that's really cool. I appreciate you guys rubbing it in that you're going to go have a good time at Vermilion while I'm at work. I'm going to go to Gussie's house and fish the KBI this year and stay up on Lake of the Woods to make up for this mess. So I was crying for a little while, okay. But I'm feeling a little better for that towards the end of the year, but I'll see you guys at Leech Lake, for the second one, hopefully. Keep my fingers crossed something pops up. But once again, I just want to say thanks to everybody for all the support and helping us grow this business out of Minnesota here. So good luck to all the anglers this year. We're looking forward to it.
All right. Thank you, Pete.
Thank you, Pete.
Thanks, Pete.
Andy, you got any last words?
No, just excited to get fishing and, excited to fish the team trail. It's been my favorite tournament trail. Like Pete was saying earlier, there's been a pretty big gap of one that covered everywhere and had everybody involved. And this is the first one I've been able to be involved in, not as a co-angler. I did like the Silverado Pro-Ams way back in the day. A few co's when I was first kind of getting my feet wet. And, this is like the first one I feel that I've had a good opportunity to fish since then. And it really excites me. I'm super happy to be a part of it. And I can't wait to kick the season off and see everybody and, you know, shake everyone's hands in the morning and yeah, go fish it. It's going to be a great season.
It's going to be a great season. We really appreciate you guys and and Keith too, of course.
Most of the time.
So, but again, Lake Vermilion, May 22nd, going out of Fortune Bay. So keep an eye out. We'll be live streaming as best we can, depending on coverage up there, but it'll go up on a YouTube channel. I want to thank everybody for coming. Pete from Omnia, Andy Walls, Keith Tuma, who was in and out. But we appreciate Keith very, very much. He's a great angler. Just wouldn't be the same without you guys on the trail. It really wouldn't. So I appreciate that. Thank you for coming tonight. For all you viewers out there, like and subscribe. Our YouTube channel is Minnesota Bass Nation. This should be up probably in the next couple of days, I'm sure.
Yep, my goal is to have it all up on
the weekend. YouTube channel. So I appreciate that, guys. Have a good evening, and we will see you at Vermilion.
Take care, gentlemen.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
See ya.